And now, seasonal messages with Pastor Franklin O. Aboagye, the founder and general overseer of the House of Prayer Outreach Ministry International and a servant to the Open Door Mission Church, Germany. Now, the word.
Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for the power of your word. Thank you for the ability to present your word. Thank you for the opportunity to present your word to your children, O God. Father, I give you praise and I give you glory in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord, my God, for this time, for this power time, for this glorious time. Your word is coming to your children, O God. Your word is coming to empower your children. I give you praise and I give you glory. Thank you, Lord, my God. Bless you, Lord, my God, for everything that you have done and everything that you're going to do. I honor you, Father. I give you praise, O God, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you, we bless you in Jesus' name. I honor you, Lord, my God. I bless you, Lord, my God, for the power of God, for the glory of God. In the name of Jesus, Lord, as I minister your word, let your people be touched. Let your glory be seen. I know that, Lord, my God, you have apportioned this word to bless somebody, to break the barriers for somebody, to release somebody your promise. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Bless you, Lord. In the name of Jesus, I give you praise and I give you glory in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The word is entitled, Enter Your Promise. Enter Your Promise. Child of God, the Lord says, enter your promise. Even though things have gone wrong, even though things have gone in a pear shape, even though things have gone in a way that you never expected, the Lord says, enter your promise. Where is your promise? Your promise is found in the word of God. Your promise is found in the word of God. There comes a time in our lives that everything seems to go wrong. There comes a time in our lives that everything seems to go wrong and there is nothing we can do about it. But the Lord says, my word is available. My word is available. And the word of God is available for you, my child. The word of God is available for you. The Lord says, I've exalted my word above my name. And today the Lord is ministering to you on another level. The Lord says, enter your promise. Enter your promise. The promise that God has given you, it's time to enter that promise. The promise that God has given you is like a house. And when you enter that house, you are enjoying, you are gloriously enjoying the house that God has given you. Enter the promise of God, child of God. Enter the promise of God. I want to bring your mind to the word of God in Genesis chapter 4. Now, Genesis chapter 4, this is a story of the first family. The first family that ever lived on this earth, the family of Adam and Eve. And the family of Adam and Eve, there were two sons in the family. Oh, the honor of two sons, the first sons in this earth of ours. These were Cain and Abel. And everything was going right, everything was going great, until the day that these people went to the house of God. They went to the house of God to give a sacrifice. Everything was all right until then. There are times in your life that you think you have gone all the way to the house of God, only to renew the problems that you once had, only to see the problems mounting up, only to see things going wrong. When it happens that way, many people get discouraged. But the Lord is saying to you tonight, the Lord is saying to you today, that even though you have seen dark days, I am telling you, my child, good days are about to come. Good days are about to come. But this is not the story of Cain and Abel. Because Cain and Abel gave sacrifices to the Lord, and suddenly, trouble started in that family. A lot of things went wrong in that family. So many things went wrong in that family. So many things went wrong in that family. Oh my goodness, how can it be that after sacrificing to the Lord, bad things begin to happen? Child of God, I'm telling you today, as you're listening, you have said to me, you have said to me that I have done everything that I have to do in the house of God. I have served the man of God. I have done everything that I have to do, but nothing seemed to go right for me. Child of God, I want to tell you something. The word of God is available to you, and the word of God is giving you a promise. Nowadays, people are moving away from the word of God and trying to just listen to prophecies. When you listen to a prophecy that has no basis to the word of God, this is not a good prophecy. A prophecy must be aligned to the word of God. People have left the word of God and are listening to baseless prophets. Baseless prophecies. I want to tell you, any word of the Lord that comes to you is a prophecy. The word of the Lord is a prophecy. The book of the Bible, the words, the rhema is prophecy. And today the Lord is making a new prophecy for your life. The Lord is establishing a new prophecy for your life, that even though things went wrong, you are going to move on to another level. You are telling me, man of God, you don't know what I'm going through. You don't know what I'm going through. Everything started going wrong for me the day I stepped in the house of God. Everything started going wrong for me the day I gave my belief to the Christendom. I gave everything I had just to believe God, but everything went wrong. Child of God, I'm telling you, you have not believed the stone. You have believed the Most High God. You have believed a God that lives. You have believed a God. You have not come unto a dead wood. You have come unto Mount Zion. You have come unto the God that lives and forever lives. And today the Lord is saying to you, my child, I will come to you and you will enter your promise. Today I'm speaking to you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And I'm telling you that your promise has been established. Nothing can take your promise away. Nothing can take your promise away. Even though Cain and Abel had this issue, and this issue may be just the issue you're going through. Now, what was the problem in the house of Adam and Eve? Abel was dead, and Cain was gone. How the first family, a family with so much promise, get into a situation where their sons were gone? Cain was gone. Abel was dead. Oh my goodness. There is a family right now. You have just suffered two losses, and you don't even know how you're going to get yourself together. I'm telling you something. The Lord's word is about to come to you. The Lord's word is about to come to you in a way you've never seen it before. The Lord's power is about to rule your life, child of God. The power of the Lord is coming for you. The fire of the Lord is coming to surround you, to take you from this sorrow that you feel. I'm telling you right now, the power of the Lord is your portion. The power of the Lord is your portion. Disappointments may have come in your life. Disappointments may have ruled your life. But I'm telling you something. The Lord's power is your portion. The Bible says in Genesis chapter 4, verse 25, the Lord is saying that in this time of loss, in this time where Adam and Eve were brooding over the two losses, they were brooding over the fact that Abel was dead and Cain was gone. Suddenly, oh my goodness. You see, whilst you are brooding in the pain, while you are brooding in the loss, something else is growing. Whilst you are brooding in the loss, the Lord is growing something beautiful inside of you. While they were brooding in the loss, Adam and Eve were blessed, but they were not aware. They were blessed, but they were not aware. They were blessed. They were being blessed. The Bible says, And Seth was born. And Seth was born. You see, interestingly, amazingly, a child's house was being nursed in the womb of Eve at the time they were brooding the loss of Cain and Abel. In the time they were brooding this loss, something was growing. I'm telling you, child of God, while you are brooding your loss, something is growing inside of you. Something is making its way out into the open. Something is coming out, even though it's a dark tunnel. Something glorious is coming out. Something glorious is coming out. The power of God is coming out. Something glorious is coming out. Child of God, the Bible makes me understand that when Seth was born, man began to seek the face of the Lord. You think you have lost something. You think that the day of your life has come to an end. But I'm telling you honestly, the Lord says, Seth was born. Then man began to seek the face of the Lord. Your new miracle is coming. And this miracle is not just meant for you alone. It's coming in a way you've never seen before. It's coming in a way you've never seen before. Men will begin to seek the face of the Lord because of you. Men will begin to seek the face of the Lord because of your miracle. Some people will run to the Lord just because of your miracle. It may feel like disaster, but I'm telling you, the Bible says Seth was born. Seth was born. Look, even though Cain was gone and Abel was dead, there came a new day in the life of Adam and Eve when Seth was born. But when Seth was born, that was not the end. The Bible said joy came to the family, but that was not the end. The Bible said a new miracle was birthed in the family, but that was not the end. The Bible says man began to seek the face of the Lord. When the disaster came, it felt like that was the end of the life. It felt like that was the end of everything. But the Bible says, Seth was born. I'm telling you right now, whatever you're going through, some Seth is about to be born. Some miracle is about to come into your life. You may feel lonely. You may feel disaster. You may feel like there's a disaster hanging around your neck. You may feel like everything has gone wrong. You may feel like everything has gone beset. You may think that everything has gone pear-shaped, but the Lord is saying, man, begin to seek the face of the Lord because of your miracle. Because of your miracle. Men, people will begin to run to the salvation of the Lord. You will cause a traffic jam in the way of the kingdom. You will cause a traffic jam in the way of the kingdom because people will hear your miracle. People will hear your miracle and they will be blessed. The Bible makes me understand also in the life of Isaac. There came a time in the life of Isaac. Oh my goodness, something happened terribly in the life of Isaac. That Isaac in Genesis 24, Isaac had lost the mother. Isaac lost the mother. In Genesis 24, Isaac was sad. Isaac was brooding in sorrow. Isaac was brooding in sorrow. But there was a time in Isaac's life that Isaac did something. He did something tremendously. Isaac in Genesis 22, Isaac allowed himself, a strong bull strength. Isaac allowed himself to be overpowered by an old weakling, an old man, Abraham, to be laid on the altar. When Isaac allowed himself to be laid on the altar, immediately Isaac was laid on the altar. Somebody was born. Somebody was born. Somebody that was to be a miracle in Isaac's life in the future was born. And the Bible makes me understand that in Genesis chapter 24, when Isaac was brooding over the life of, over the loss of the life of Sarah, his mother, that was Isaac's joy. Isaac's joy was gone. But the Bible says, oh my goodness, the Bible says
in Genesis 24:67 that when Isaac met Rebecca, the same girl that was born on the day Isaac was laid on the altar, the same day Isaac was laid on the altar, that Rebecca that was born, this Rebecca came into Isaac's life as his wife. You have no idea what you are doing to your life as you are sacrificing to the things of God. Please, child of God, when you sacrifice to the things of God, when you give for the kingdom of God, when you give for the work of the Lord, when you donate to the work of the Lord, when you give to the work of the Lord, something is being written for you. A record is established in heaven. When you give to the work of God, something breaks loose for you. When you give to the work of God, something is born in the secret. When you do the things of God, something is born in the secret. Nothing can be taken out of your hand when you do ministry, when you give to the work of God, when you give of your increase, when you give of your increase, when you support the work of God, when you give yourself, when you decide, I'm going to support God's work, I'm going to support God's work with my substance, with my substance. Some people give their first salary. Some people give things to the Lord. Some people give great things to the Lord. Some people establish even one man's salary, they give to the Lord. Some people give sacrifices that you can't even think of. Some people give houses to the men of God, to the women of God, to the people in ministry. Some people build churches for ministry. Some people build orphanages. Some people build great things. Some people do things that people cannot even understand. And at the time of need, the Lord comes to you. Isaac was in on the altar. Isaac was on the altar at the time. And at that time, Isaac was on the altar. Rebecca was born. And this same Rebecca, the Bible says this same Rebecca, oh my goodness, in Genesis 24:67, Bible says Isaac was comforted from the mother's death. The Rebecca that was born on the day Isaac laid on the altar has become a source of joy to Isaac. When you are in that situation, something you did in the past will speak for you. Your offering will speak for you. Your sacrifice will speak for you. The glory of God will speak for you. The power of God will speak for you, child of God. The Lord is saying to you right now, whatever you give is speaking for you. Whatever you give is speaking for you. Whatever you give, when you laid on the altar, when you laid your offering on the altar, that is speaking for you. And today the Lord is saying, whatever you have laid on the altar, it will speak for you. Father, there is somebody here who has only received disaster when they gave their offering. Today I break that disaster in the name of Jesus. I declare from now onwards, your offering will count. Your offering will count. Cornelius, his offering became a memorial before God. Cornelius, his offering became a memorial. A memorial is like a story building before God. And God caused Cornelius to receive one of the best miracles in the area of salvation and anointing. There is no way your miracle will not count. There is no way your miracle will not count. There is no way your record will not count. There is no way your sacrifice will not count. Your sacrifice will count. Your miracle will count. Your glory will count. Everything around you will start to count. And people will see the glory of God in your life. Child of God, I'm telling you something. The Lord is about to break forth for you. Isaac saw his sorrow disappear. Because when he was laid on the altar, someone was born. In the secret. You see, the point is that in the secret, when you were going through that problem, when you were going through that challenge, in the secret, something was born to account for your glory. I want to bring you to the life of Jacob. Bible makes me understand in the life of Jacob was also in a similar situation. Jacob has served. He has served his father-in-law to be. His father-in-law to be was Laban. Jacob has served Laban. If you look at Genesis 29, Jacob has served Laban. He served Laban for 7 years. 7 years he served Laban. 7 years he served Laban. That to get the wife of his dream, Rachel. Now guess what the Bible says in Genesis 29:25, and it came to pass in the morning, behold, it was Leah. I mean, how can this be that he has worked everything? He has worked everything. He has done everything that needed to be done. He had done everything. He had done his part of the deal. He has done everything that has to be done. There is somebody here. You have not been paid for the past 7 months. The Lord is restoring your salary right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Lord is restoring your salary right now. The Lord says, your salary will come back to you. In the mighty name of Jesus, all the years that the canker worm and the palmer worm and the caterpillar had eaten, I will restore to you, says the Lord. The Lord is saying to somebody right now, whatever you lost is coming back to you. Jacob found himself in that place. He worked for 7 years for a reward. A 7 years work, 7 years of sweat, 7 years of sweat. He woke up in the morning and the person that was supposed to be his wife was not. There was a different person there. How would you feel when you are waking up in the morning thinking that your dreams have come to pass and it's a nightmare? Jacob found himself in that situation. Jacob found himself in that. He said, and when it came to pass that in the morning, behold, it was Leah. It was not Rachel. His dreams have been shattered. How can it be that you have waited for 7 years only to be disappointed? And I believe you were thinking, oh, 7 is the number of God. Oh, I've done everything that the prophecy said. I've done everything according to the word of God. Oh, the prophet was speaking to me and then made a prophetic statement in my life. And everything that was done was according to the word of God. I believe the prophecy. I've waited and waited only for it to come to a negative end. Somebody waited and waited all these 9 months to give birth only to a stillborn. But I'm going to declare to you right now that the Lord is saying to you right now, my child, you will give birth to your child. You will give birth to your child. And when you give birth to your child, give me a call and say, man of God, I have done it. God has done it for me. I have seen the face of my child, and I will see your child. I will see your child in the realms of the spirit. Oh, I will see your child. I'll see your child in your joy. Even if my eyes may not see your child because you are in China or you are in anywhere, any part of the world, or you are in the US or wherever you are in South America, wherever you are that you are listening to this message, if you get your child, just a picture of the child to me will be enough, because I believe that God is bringing you to another level. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for this prophecy. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for fulfilling somebody's desire. Somebody is receiving your child. You are receiving your child. The stillborn is no more. I curse stillborn. I curse disappointment. I curse the spirit of disappointment right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Somebody's right here. You have been calling all the offices you know about, but none of them is responding to you. None of them is responding to you. Joblessness seems to be a curse around you, but today I break that spirit of joblessness in the mighty name of Jesus, and I declare that the power of God is your portion in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says, behold, it came to pass in the morning, it was Leah, not Rachel. But I declare to you, even though you were disappointed, yet the Lord is coming to you. The Bible says, Jacob wept another 7 years for Rachel. Another 7 years, Jacob worked for Rachel. But guess what? The 7 years came like 7 days. The 7 years came like 7 days. Your time will run. Your time will run like a high-speed train. Your time will run to the day of your fulfillment. The time is running to the day where it will be fulfilled. The time will run. Oh my goodness. Bless your name, oh God. Bless your name, oh God. The time is running. The time is running. The time is running. You are a sweatless overtaker. You are overtaking left, right, center. You are going to your fulfillment. You are going to the promised land. The power of the Lord is your portion, child of God. I'm telling you right now. I'm telling you right now. You are crossing over. You are crossing over from disappointment into appointment. You are crossing over from a bad year to a good year. You are crossing over from disappointment into joy. You are crossing over from joblessness into multi-million job. You are crossing over from a time of disappointment to a time of signing a big time contract. Oh my God. My God is breaking forth for you. He says, I've opened before you a door that no man can shut. Oh yes, Lord my God. Father, I give you praise and I give you glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for this power. Thank you for this power. You are giving your child. You are giving your child a great miracle. You are giving your child a great miracle. Nothing can stop this miracle. Oh, the Bible makes me understand. In 1 Samuel. In 1 Samuel, something happened in 1 Samuel. Something terrible happened in 1 Samuel. And in this situation, the Bible makes me understand that the children of Israel were in a big, big problem. They were in a big, big problem. And in this big problem, something very terrible happened to the people of Israel. Oh my goodness. Something happened to the people of Israel. The Bible makes me understand in 1 Samuel chapter 4 that Israel went to battle and they were defeated. They were so defeated. They were so defeated, broken into pieces, defeated in a way that they've never seen before. The Bible makes me understand in Genesis chapter 4 that the defeat was so strong. It was such a shameful defeat that the ark of God was taken. The ark of God was taken. And when the high priest heard that the ark of God was taken, Bible said that the high priest fell down and broke his neck and died. The first and second son of the high priest were killed. And the Bible makes me understand that the wife of one of the sons, Israel's glory was ready to give birth. The ark of God was taken. The glory had departed. Everything went wrong. Thousands and thousands of people were dead. Israel, blood was flowing. Israel had lost people in battle. Thousands and thousands were lost. There was defeat. There was bad news. There was everything. The ark of God was taken by the Philistines and kept in the temple of Dagon. But I tell you, while Israel had suffered defeat, thousands and thousands were dead. Ichabod was born. Eli died. Hophni and Phinehas dead. Wife of one of them dead. But in the secret place where no one was present, in the temple of Dagon, the people, the attendants of the altar went to the altar, and behold, something scary had happened. Dagon was bowing before the ark of God. Dagon was bowing before the ark of God. I want to tell you something, child of God. Even though everything seemed to go wrong against you, even though everything seemed to be working against you, I'm telling you right now, as you hear this word, as you hear this word of God, as you hear this prophetic word, as you hear this word that is coming right into your spirit, the word is building something in you. As you are listening to this word, something is coming, it's stirring inside of you. It's giving you the power to pray. Something is telling you to get up and start to fire in prayer. Because I'm telling you, the evil altar is bowing. The evil altar is bowing. That fetish priest in your village that has done evil things against you is bowing to the ark of God. That evil shrine that is doing evil things against you is bowing to the ark of God. That witcher spirit that has been mandating evil against your life is bowing. All the things that were going wrong against you, they are bowing. They are bowing to the ark of God. They are bowing to the word of God. They are bowing to the prophecy of God. The Bible says, let my people go. Let my people go. Let my people go. I'm telling you right now, even though things are going wrong, the Lord says, let my people go. Let my people go. Hallelujah, hallelujah. The fire of the Lord is your portion right now. The power of the Lord is your portion right now. The Lord is doing great things for you right now. The Lord is empowering you right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, begin to pray, begin to pray. Ramakabo Shandala Brande. In the mighty name of Jesus, the power of the Lord is right here. In the mighty name of Jesus, I break every spirit of disappointment. I break every spirit of disappointment. I break every filthy spirit assigned against you. I condemn every filthy spirit working against you. I declare, even though you face that disappointment, but the Lord is turning it around. The Lord is turning it around. Child of God, the Lord is turning it around. Begin to pray. Rise on your feet and pray. Rise on your feet and pray. Today's Lord, the Lord's word has come to you. Today's word has come to you to empower you to pray, to empower you with a new level, with a new covenant. I'm telling you, Dagon is bowing. Dagon is bowing. Dagon is bowing. Bowing to the ark of God. Bowing to your prayer. Bowing to the covenant of God in your life. The Lord is moving powerfully. The Lord is moving powerfully. Like a battle drawn. 50 million soldiers. Soldiers are going against your enemies. Crushing every enemy. Destroying every enemy. The Lord is fighting for you, child of God. Begin to pray right now. Begin to pray right now. Establish prayer right now. Establish prayer right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. The fire of the Lord is here. The fire of the Lord is here. The power of the Lord is here. Nothing can stop you, child of God. Nothing can stop you. Enter your promise. Your promise has come. Your promise has come. The disappointment is over. The promise has come. Riamalarabakandoroboshan. The disappointment is over. The job contract has been established. You have signed a multi-million contract. Oh yes, Lord my God. The power of the Lord is here. The fire of the Lord is here. Your honor has come. The time of your honor has come. You have done good in the house of God. It's time to receive your reward. You have been faithful in the house of God. The time has come to receive your reward. Receive your reward, child of God. Nothing can stop you. Nothing can stop you. The power of the Lord is here. The power of the Lord is here. Oh, your promise has come. Your promise has come. Enjoy. Begin to dance. Begin to dance. Begin to dance. Dance to the glory of God. Your victory has come in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I thank you. Father, I bless you for your mighty word. I know you will never let us down or put us to shame. I know your power has been ministered. I know your word has been ministered. And I know your people have taken your word. They are entering their promise. The promise has come. They have entered their promise according to your word. According to your word. Lord, somebody is right here. They have believed this word so much. And they are going to take a new step. The Lord says, my child, take that new step. Take that bold step. Nothing can stop you. Take the bold step. The bold step is your portion. Nothing can stop you. Enter your promise. Enter your promise. Hallelujah. Father, I give you praise and I give you glory. I honor you, Lord, my God. I bless you, Lord. I bless you, Lord, for your child. Your child. Your child has received a new miracle. Somebody is receiving a letter confirming something great. Somebody is receiving it. Trust the Lord that the Lord is going to speak on your behalf. Somebody, your interview is going to be successful as you listen to the word of God. Somebody, you're going to receive great glory. Good news is coming. I stop every spirit of bad news in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to pray right now in the name of Jesus. Father Lord my God, I declare your fire. Your fire. Yes, Lord my God. There's somebody here. You can't sleep at night, but the Lord is saying, the pillar of fire by night. I release the pillar of fire by night. The Bible says that the Israelites traveled at night because of the pillar of fire. I release the pillar of fire by night in the name of Jesus. The pillar of fire by night. As you sleep in the night, I release the pillar of fire. I pour the blood of Jesus on your bed. As you sleep tonight, let the pillar of fire go in front of you and set out all the enemies and kill them before the morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I give you praise and I give you glory. Thank you, Lord, for ministering your word in such power. For ministering your word, your love for your people is tremendous. And I give you praise and I give you glory. Thank you, Lord, my God, in the mighty name of Jesus. People of God, I want you to take this as a sign to begin praying. Your prayer will move you to another level. Your prayer, you cannot take this word and take it just face value. You have to pray to get to your promised land. You have to pray to enter. The key to enter your promised land is prayer. Pray yourself into the door. Pray yourself into the door. And that key of prayer will open that door. The Lord's blessing is on your life. I see you blessed. I see you blessed. I see you blessed and highly favored. Child of God, I love you. God's love is on your life. God's love and favor is on your life. Take this word and move into action in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Every time I think about you, every time I read about you, every time I hear your name, I start to smile. Every time the sun starts shining,